still things to develop.
Step! Hold!
Center, please.
Spiritual development plays an important part in the making of a United States Marine. Lieutenant Victor Stevens, Chaplain Corps, United States Navy, will deliver the graduation prayer. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
Let us pray. Lord, we come before you this day, and we are a thankful people. Lord, we are thankful that we might be able to participate in a milestone event such as today's graduation. Lord, I pray and I ask that you would allow all those that are gathered here today to feel that they have continued and they have supported their Marine that's going to walk across this parade deck here momentarily. Lord, I pray and I ask that they would know that their encouragement and their support played a big part in them being able to come and accomplish this goal that they set out. And Lord, of course, we pray for those Marines that will graduate here today, for we know that this graduation is not an end, but a beginning to where they may go. Some may go far, some may stay close. Some may find themselves in peril. And Lord God, we pray and we ask that they would know that you are ever present, that you are there with them wherever they may find themselves. That Lord, we may always look to you and know that you are truly Semper Fidelis, always faithful. This we do pray and we ask in your righteous and holy name. Amen.
Thank you. Please be seated.
Take your post.
The commanding general, Marine Corps Recruit Depot, San Diego, welcomes you to what is a historical event in the life of a Marine, their graduation from boot camp. Approximately 40 weeks each year for the past 100 years, new Marines have departed San Diego for service with units of the Marine Corps around the globe. The primary mission of the Recruit Depot is to provide basic training to recruits enlisted west of the Mississippi, which represents approximately 51% of all applicants in the Marine Corps each year. The depot is also home to Recruiter School and Drill Instructor School. All of our efforts here are geared toward one end, producing America's finest fighting force, the United States Marine Corps. This morning, Company B, 1st Recruit Training Battalion, Recruit Training Regiment, will form and march in the parade. Following the pass and review, the graduating Marines will return front and center of the reviewing stand for final dismissal. The staff for today's parade is comprised of Marines from the Recruit Training Regiment. The command of troops is Captain Alec Reddy, and the parade adjutant is Captain Vincent P. Everman. Are now being called to attention, and the adjutant's command, sound adjutant's call, will begin today's parade.
Oh, adjutant's call!
Corporal 2, 1,034. Corporal Zachary R. Nielsen. the crew training and comprise of subjects required to produce basic Marines who function effectively in garrison. Are trained in rudimentary individual field and combat skills, and practice the versatile and professional traits which distinguishes them as Marines. Examples of these traits are discipline, the achievement of self-control and self-awareness, which assures respect for authority, instant and willing obedience to orders, and the self-reliance to maintain or improve those traits which exemplify a Marine. Military bearing. Consistently demonstrating military presence and personal awareness, as well as the proper wearing and maintenance of uniforms. Esprit de corps, acquiring the common spirit of the Marine Corps that inspires enthusiasm, devotion, pride, initiative, teamwork, aggressiveness, determination, moral courage, integrity, camaraderie, and a burning desire to work with and for others towards excellence in common goals. For 248 years, Marines have fought and won whenever and wherever the nation calls. In the harshest conditions, over the most brutal terrain, and against the most formidable enemies, Marines defend the ideas of freedom with grit and tenacity. Although battlefields change and capabilities evolve, history proves that true victory comes from an individual Marine with steeled resolve, a drive to overcome any obstacle, and the warrior's spirit to fight on against all odds. It takes that steadfast faithfulness, semper fidelis, to Corps, country, and each other that abounds throughout our storied legacy. Marines today remain in combat or deployed throughout the world, confronting every challenge with courage, loyalty, and faithfulness. They are resolved to be the most ready when the nation is least ready. To defend freedom, anytime and anywhere. To stand ready to aid those devastated by natural disasters. To pay tribute to those who have forged our proud legacy. And to honor the families and loved ones who faithfully stand beside us. For the Marines of Company B, today marks the end of the 13-week recruit training cycle. They have marched countless miles at Camp Pendleton, as well as on this parade day, and have been trained as our all Marines as basic riflemen. In addition, due to an intensive physical training program, their strength and endurance have doubled since their arrival aboard the recruit depot. They are Marines, qualified to take their places in the ranks of the world's finest fighting organization. Platoons are now being aligned from left to right in order to get them into their exact positions for the parade. The next portion of the ceremony will be our national anthem. We welcome veterans and members of the armed forces to join us in rendering appropriate honors with a military salute. For guests who have not served in the military, it is proper etiquette during the national anthem to place their right hands over their hearts, and for those in the audience wearing headgear to remove it. Will the guests please rise for the presentation of the colors? Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem. Thank you. Please be seated. At the command, post the colors. The color guard moves into position within the parade. This signifies that the entirety of the parade has been formed and is ready to be presented to the command. Following the command, parade rest, the parade adjutant will give the command sound gun. It's the band to the record of the assigned Marines while playing military marching music.
Thank you.
The parade adjutant now presents the assembled command to the commander of troops.
Thank you.
Nation's history, millions of men and women have earned the title United States Marine. Many who have helped shape our history join us here today. In keeping with the tradition of once a Marine, always a Marine, we would like to recognize them. At this time, those in the audience who have served as Marines, please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for the dedicated service to Corps. Ladies and gentlemen, the battalion commander for 1st Recruit Training Battalion, Lieutenant Colonel Roger A. Hollenbeck.
Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the commanding general, Brigadier General Ryans, and Regimental Commander Colonel Rumler, welcome to Marine Corps Recruit Depot San Diego and the graduation ceremony for Bravo. I'd like to extend the impressive bios you'll hear in a moment. First, joining us from the Mighty One Marine Expeditionary Force just up the road on Camp Pendleton is Colonel Moran, currently serving as Assistant Chief of Staff for Plans, G5. Additionally, we have another guest today, a veteran of the Marine Corps and the Army, who served in World War II, Korea, and Vietnam, Major Billy Hall, retired. Gentlemen, welcome. Today's ceremony recognizes your new Marines and all they've accomplished in the last 13 weeks. Gathering here as individuals from all walks of life and all corners of the globe, they stepped onto the legendary yellow footprints and into uncertainty. They dug deep. They trained hard. They came together and stand before you as a confident team of Marines, the best this nation has to offer. So I'd like to thank those that made it possible. The foundation of their character wasn't made here. It was made in your homes, in your schools, and in your communities. So thank you, the parents, teachers, families, friends, coaches. Your love, your support for some of our younger Marines, your signature on that contract set conditions vital to their success. So thank you. Give yourselves a round of applause, please. To our outstanding drill instructors who spent literally every moment teaching, training, mentoring, and leading the Marines, their dedication and commitment has left a tremendous impact on your loved one, who will always remember and appreciate their efforts. Now, the drill instructors and officers are able to commit themselves to the business of making the Marines because of the love and support of their families and friends who also join us in the audience today. So if you would please join me in a well-deserved round of applause for the drill instructors and families of Bravo Company. I'd also like to recognize our martial arts, marksmanship, water survival, and academics instructors, our outstanding chaplain, foreman, and the entire medical team. Done a tremendous job keeping us physically, mentally, and spiritually strong. And of course, the dedicated recruiter that saw potential in your Marine. In fact, joining us from Weapons Field Training Battalion is Corporal Nielsen, responsible for training the platoon with the highest rifle qualification score. And joining us from recruiting substation Tempe, Arizona, is Sergeant Contrabasso, responsible for recruiting today's honor graduate, who is a tremendous young man. Outstanding work, Marines. Please excuse me while I address the nation's newest Marines for one last time as a battalion commander. Good morning, Marines. You made it to graduation. You earned the Eagle Globe and Anchor, and you earned the look of pride on your loved one's face across this parade. It took you 13 weeks to earn this feeling, but it doesn't stop here. We promised you a challenge, and we will continue to deliver. You must continue to earn the title every day to honor the legacy of those that came before you and to blaze a trail for the next wave of warriors. The Marine Corps will be what you make it. So never forget the skills, the spirit, and the values that have been drilled into you, and I guarantee your success. You represent the Marine Corps now. You are the future of this great institution. You are my replacement and the replacement of your drill instructor. So stand tall, take charge, and when you get home, I want you to introduce all your buddies to your local recruit. Congratulations, Marines. Thank you for your hard work and for your dedication to serve this great nation of ours. This nation needs her Marines. Take care of each other. Cultivate the relationships you've made with your fellow Marines. They will serve you well. Welcome to the Corps, Semper Fidelis.
Taking their positions in the reviewing area are today's Grade Review officials, Colonel Kobe M. Moran, 1st Marine Expeditionary Force, Assistant Chief of Staff, G5, as well as Major Billy Charles Hall, United States Marine Corps and United States Army, retired. A native of Seattle, Washington, and was commissioned in 1995 through the Naval Reserve Officer Training Corps at the University of Michigan. After graduating the basic school, Colonel Moran reported to Infantry Officers Corps and obtained the military occupational specialty of 0302 Infantry Officer. He has served in a variety of John G. billets in numerous commands to include Platoon Commander at 2nd Battalion, 6th Marine Regiment, Infantry Programs Actions Officer at Marine Corps Systems Command, Company Commander and Battalion Operations Officer at 1st Battalion, 4th Marine Regiment, Company Commander and Warfighting Instructor at the Basic School, Lance Officer and Future Operations Officer at 3rd Marine Logistics Group, Battalion Commander at 2nd Battalion, 1st Marine Regiment, Campaign Plans Branch Chief at United States Africa Command, military assistant to the assistant secretary of the Navy at Manpower and Reserve Affairs, and the commanding officer for Infantry, School of Infantry West, Marine Corps Base, Camp Pendleton, California. Colonel Moran is a combat veteran and participated in two tours during Operation Iraqi Freedom, tsunami relief operations in Japan in support of Operation Tomodachi, and supported counter-ISIS operations during Operation Inherent Resolve while deployed with the 11th Marine Expeditionary Unit. Colonel Moran currently serves as Assistant Chief of Staff, G5, 1st Marine Expeditionary Force General Staff. His awards include the Legion of Merit, the Bronze Star Medal with Combat B, the Navy and Marine Corps Achievement Medal with Combat B, and the Presidential Unit Citation. Major Billy Charles Hall is believed to be the last living veteran who enlisted before World War II and seek combat in World War II, Korea, and Vietnam. Major Hall enlisted in the Marine Corps in August of 1941 at the age of 15 and a half years old, 4 months before Pearl Harbor, and graduated from Marine Corps Group Depot San Diego. He has served in a variety of challenging billets in numerous commands to include radio man and gunner in Douglas SDD Dauntless Dive Bombers. He deployed to Guadalcanal in August of 1942, engaging the enemy over the Solomon Islands, including Peleliu and Mudug, in ship convoy cover, strafing in support of ground troops and fire and dive bombing, and later in TBF Avenger torpedo bombers on anti-submarine patrols and glide bombing enemy ships, flying 100 combat missions at 16 and 17 years old. Radio man and gunner instructor. In 1943, he was assigned to California as a radio man and gunner instructor, but returned to action in 1945 at Peleliu, flying 50 TBF anti-submarine and enemy shipping patrol missions and bombing runs on Japanese installations at Bougainville until the war ended. Army Infantry and Communications Officer. He joined the California National Guard in 1948 and was deployed to Korea in 1951. Billy retrained as a pilot and then became a helicopter pilot and delivered 3 companies of helicopters, totaling 75 helicopters to Vietnam. Billy was in country for the next 9 months, flying over 50 insertion, extraction, supply, and medevac missions in the QED slick model. Major Billy C. Hall served our country from 1941 to 1967, 5 of those years in actual combat in 3 wars. Major Billy Hall is proof why he and his American contemporaries are called the greatest generation the world has ever known. At 97 years old, Major Billy Hall co-founded the You Were Worth It Foundation to always remember our veterans and never forget our active duty and welcome home all service members. Major Billy Hall was awarded the Air Medal with 3 blushes for extraordinary achievement and meritorious acts in aerial flight, the World War II Victory Medal, the Asiatic Pacific Medal, the American Campaign Medal, the Bronze Star, the Combat Infantry Badge, the Korean Service Medal, and the Vietnam Service Medal. In October of 1941, Major Billy Charles Hall earned his Eagle Globe and Anchor, making this the 83rd anniversary of graduating from Marine Corps Recruit Depot, San Diego. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Colonel Kobe M. Moran and Major Billy Charles Hall.
Gentlemen!
The Basin Review is a tradition within all military units, allowing the unit commander to formally inspect the unit under their charge.
Thank you. Thank you.
the most important thing we do, the Marine Corps is Marines. We think it is the Marines, here, the Corps. That is what we do. For the Marines, that's what we do. The long time is the last day of the Marines. The first one is the Marine Corps. And we're the best of the Captain Alec Reddy. The company first sergeant is First Sergeant Omar Garcia. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a round of applause for the company staff of Florida Company. The next portion of the ceremony will be the traditional function of retiring the guidons.
Thank you.
presented a flag by the battalion commander, Lieutenant Colonel Roger A. Holliday, and the battalion sergeant major, First Sergeant Jonathan Mejia. Ladies and gentlemen, please hold your applause until all honor graduates have been recognized.
Peace and heart.
The Honor Graduate for Platoon 1031 and the Company Honor Graduate is Lance Corporal Trey D. Morocco from 8th Creek, Arizona. Lance Corporal Morocco is also recipient of the Chesapeake Bull Award for his outstanding meritorious performance while in recruit training. The Honor Graduate for Platoon 1033 is Private First Class Jacob D. Morris from Liberty Hill, Texas. The Honor Graduate for Platoon 1034 and the Series Honor Graduate is Private First Class Sergio P. Flores from Anaheim, California. And the Honor Graduate for Platoon 1035 is Private First Class Anthony W. Najera Diaz from Menifee, California. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honor Graduates of Bravo Company.
Senior drill instructors to dismiss the platoon. Needless to say, this will be the most welcome command I can see to Robert Bertrand. Senior drill instructors!